Hey guys, how you doing today? It's me, Kelly. So a couple things I'm going to show you today. Just real quick tips. New obsession of mine, and I'm going to be doing videos on it, is the Lisa Pavelka Magic Gloss. And I'm obsessed. And I'm going to do a whole video on this because there's good and bad. And I want to make sure that you guys know and don't have to go through returning and doing all kinds of crazy stuff to find one that works. So I love this stuff. I've been obsessively playing with it and I've been making eyeballs. All right. All right. And that's what this is made of and has some glitter on the back, but this is, this will be a video coming up because I'm quite obsessed with the, it's a resin, it's a clear resin. So I'm very, very obsessed. Now, the next thing I want to show you guys is, quite a few of you have asked me to make another wall hanging, and you can see this is just a wall hanging I did a while ago, and I have a video on it, but you know, it's with puffy paint and different, you know, stitches and all these kind of things, and it's a wall hanging, and I have it, you know, I have a copper thing to hang on the wall. So I will be doing this soon. And some of you want it without the sewing, like to do something like this without the sewing. Now, I dig the sewing. So I really think it adds to it because it makes it puffy. But, you know, we'll figure something out and do it where you don't have to have the sewing machine if you don't want. And then I'll do one with the sewing machine. So we'll just be, we'll be doing it both ways for whatever way that you want to do it. Now, and I'll also be doing the baby doll with the puff. Remember doing that as the face and all, we'll be doing that. That's going to be fun. And then the last thing I want to show you is this. And what this is an ATC card, but this could be an art journal. It could be, let me move in a little bit. It could be a art journal page, canvas, whatever. And we're doing mixed media. So many of you keep writing me, asking me for more at home stuff that you can use in your mixed media for mark making, for stencils, stamps, and that kind of thing. So this is a really great one. Now you can see this is a couple ways. I used a ink pad with this, and I'll show you on the back. And then I used a spray on this one. So let me show you on the back. First, what I did, and this is just showing you different ways you can use it. You can do it in one way. I clipped it on. Let me clip it on for you. I go to clip it where I want it. This way you could clip it any way you want it, anywhere. And this can go on your paper as well, or art journal page. And I had it like that. And I took, I'm just taking some ink, and I'm going to take, and you don't have to. You could get this on any way you want, a makeup brush. But I'm just taking, you know, an ink pad and my paintbrush, and you just kind of dab it on. Okay, well, let me show you that way first. Hands aren't working. Okay, but you see how you get some of that texture on there. But maybe you just don't even want to be bothered with a brush, and you just go, and you just kind of dab it around. You know, and you have fun, and then you start making these different marks, dark, light, whatever. If you don't want to do something like that and you go to the dollar store and you get a bunch of these, what is really, really fun is taking it and laying them flat. We'll do it this way. Flat on your paper in whatever ways you want to do it, whatever style. And then giving sprays. I'm just giving it a second. This is just a this is a deco art media, which dries permanent, but of course you can use dilutions, tattered angels. I mean, the list goes on and on. You can make your own. Take your water bottle, take what color you want to do, and shake it real good. And if you have very thin, very small mica, you can put it in there. I know a lot of people use eyeshadow that they get from the dollar store, like pearlescent eyeshadow, and use that as well. I gotta see, I had everything down here to do one. I just don't have it right now. And then you can make your own. My only tip is when you're done, make sure you open the bottle when you're done using it for the day and spray this out so all the water's out. Put it back or all the ink is out, and then make sure you wipe this part really, really good so it's dry and it doesn't stick. Do not spray it again. Set it aside. 9 out of 10 times, it's not going to clog, and that's what you want. And you can go to Walmart, your local pharmacy, a dollar store. I even tell you guys, go to the dollar store and get the body spray that they sell. You pay a dollar for it. Bring it home. If you don't like the body spray, I've emptied it out. Clean out the bottle and then use that. So, and that's a buck. So, you know what I mean? You can do it if you want to. But look, no, I sprayed a little thick there. I don't care. But look at what you get. And I sprayed thick. But then you can go over, if you start light to dark, which I tell you guys all the time, if I would have done this a very light color, I could have built up, right? I could have put this way and done it and all that kind of stuff. So you get so many different ways. And you can see how different that side is because I did it lighter. So put this over here. So you see that you can play with things that aren't necessarily not necessarily made for your mixed media or your art journaling. So I think that's a lot of fun. A lot of us have those clips sitting around. Use paper clips and just lay them down. Think of things outside the norm that you could use just to make a nice, this is an ATC background. And think about doing it on art journal pages or a canvas or whatever. You can lay a bunch down if you have a bunch or just move one around all the time. Maybe you don't have one and you don't have the money. Maybe your friend has one. You know what I mean? Everybody, somebody somewhere has a bunch laying around. And if not, the dollar store has them. And you can buy a piece of poster board from the dollar store for $1. Sometimes they're three for $1. Come home and cut them in art journal page sizes you want or ATCs, whatever. A lot of fun. And just something new to play with, you know, because you guys keep asking for more and more little tips. And that is the tip I have today. So, as always, please be kind to each other. You never know what battle somebody else is fighting. I love you guys. Please share me around like I'm your loose friend. And leave me a thumbs up if you like me showing you guys some weird ideas that I have in my head for mixed media and such. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.